Hello, my lovely butterfly. It's France. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm sharing my week two a layer a day spread. I'm working in my little a layer a day art journal, which is actually small enough to put down a layer a day. But in all honesty, I have to admit that I did cheat. I did put down several layers on a couple of days because I wanted to have so much filming done to share with you that I needed to speed up this process. And while the point of the challenge is to get you to create on a daily basis, which I am, so I'm happy with that. The prompt for that week was tomorrow's goal, and we agreed on setting mini goals for each day. And I did that for a full week. I set mini tiny goals, and I started each layer by writing down that goal. For my first actual layer, I'm starting with my extra large charcoal blocks from Derwent. And as I'm working on a really, really small surface, I need to be light-handed here. Otherwise, I will just end up with powder everywhere. And to set the charcoal on the paper, I am using gesso, a paintbrush, and a baby wipe to blend it a little bit more. Coming back to it later that day, I started by writing down the second goal that I had set for myself during my week of mini goal setting. This time I wrote it down with a pigment ink fineliner just to make sure that it wouldn't move as I would go in with the next layer. For that next layer, I picked out a couple of fresco finish colors, and I will link and name all the colors that I used and all the products that I used in the description of this video. To apply my colors, I just used my trusted palette knife and I scraped the color on the paper. just like you, I don't like to waste my products. I mean, they cost money, so if I can put some paint back in the jar, I just will. I just don't like to waste them in such a stupid way. If they're ready to dry or too thin, well, I will just leave them. And as I recently changed the storage of my paint, I need to have the color on top of the lid, and that is what I just did. I want to use that particular circle later on, so I need to make sure that I'm using the mask of the correct circle for what I want to do next. But first, I'm writing down the goal that I had set for my third day. I did check with myself how I did on the goals, and based on that, I decided on what I wanted to do in my journal. Now, to make sure that my mask will stay in place, all my masks have these little openings, so I can use this washi tape to make sure that it will stay in place, especially here as I'm working over the center of my journal where it folds, and I want to make sure that it will just stay in place no matter what it is I have to do. And what I have to do, at least that's what I decided for myself, was to go in with a brayer and some white fresco finish paint and push back some of the layers that I already had in my journal. Next layer, next goal. And again, I'm starting by writing it down for myself. For this layer, I know that I'm going to do something dangerous. I'm going to spray. And it's dangerous in that sense that I just want to have it on the circle. So I need some help. And that help is coming from kitchen roll, which I will just stick to my stencil to make sure that the ink cannot go anywhere but in the opening of that circle. Thank you. I chose colors matching the paints that I already used, and although they will not bring a lot of color to it, they will enhance the texture that I have, and they will add a little bit of bling and pop to my circle. And I'm using a bit of water to blend it out. Next layer, next goal first. And as I was writing it down, I realized that I needed to make this spread mine again. It is one thing to be creative soul searching. It is another thing to do it in such a way that it remains recognizable to yourself. So I needed to do something that I would do all the time when working in my journal. And one of those things is to trace around the circle. So that is exactly what I did before moving on. Now that this was done, I could actually move on with the layer that I had in mind, which was to add molding paste over my circumambulate stencil, but going around the circle. So actually having a diagonal line going from the left bottom corner to the right top corner to pull the eye over the spread. This is one of the good things of the A Layer A Day challenge, is that you don't lose any time waiting for that paste to dry, because you just come back to it the next day when it is dry. I left it for a couple of hours though, and then I was very happy that I could actually just write my next goal under the molding paste and have my little list of goals continue as if they were all done, all written in one go. For this layer, I wanted to add some stamping. I took out one of the stamps from my London, New York stamp set, some sepia archival ink, and then I did some ghost stamping here and there in the corners where I didn't have any molding paste, just to balance it out a little bit. But, and this was the main thing that I wanted to do for this layer, was to add some copper fresco finish paint. I just wanted to add a couple of details, a couple of lines here and there within the circle. And to do that, I used a card. As I was about to take away the leftover paint, I realized that it wasn't enough to put it back in the bottle, but it was enough to add some splatters just by adding a little bit of water to it. So I picked it up with my paintbrush and then splattered it over the spread. As I was writing down my last goal of the week, I was realizing that I wanted to include in my spread just how busy my week had been and how hard it had been to incorporate these mini tiny goals. It's not because they're small that they're easy to incorporate. I knew that doing this layer would not be possible in 5 minutes. Sometimes doing a layer in 5 minutes, it's like easy peasy. And sometimes, well, you know that it will take you up more time. And that was the case for this one. I knew it before I even started with it. But the thing was that I didn't know just how I wanted to incorporate that in the spread. So I wanted to give myself some time to think. And to do that, I decided to give the molding paste a little bit of color by going in with the Lindy's Gang that I used on the circle and applying it with my palette knife just at the top of the molding paste and then spreading it out with my finger and a baby wipe. At this point, I actually knew what I wanted to do. I wanted to express me being so busy during the week by adding a bee stamp from my For the Love of Bees stamp set, just to show how much of a busy bee I had been. Like, why make it complicated when there's no need to make it complicated? And if you think that we never have accidents because we are so-called artists, well, think again. I didn't ink my stamp enough, so the first time that I stamped it, well, the design wasn't showing through enough, so I had to re-stamp it, and that's where I was happy that it wasn't in my journal, because that would not have been funny. It would not have been a disaster, but it would not have been funny. And to colorize the stamp, I just wanted to use the same Lindy's Gang that I had used on the spread already, just to keep it simple and keep it not monochromatic, because I have several colors, but keep it within the same family of colors. Thank you. When I fussy cut this kind of images, I don't bother leaving in the little legs and stuff like that or the antennas. I just cut them all off and I will add them again by stamping the image directly in my journal. And then I use a black marker to go around the image to take away the white edge from the stamped image that I just cut out. Now that I know where I want the little bee to be, I can just stamp it again directly in my journal. This way, my little animal will be complete again. And now I can just glue my colorized image on top of the stamped image. Like I said, my mini goals weren't easy to implement, and I wanted to show that on the spread by adding a little bit of drama. So I used black fresco finish paint, add a little bit of water to it, and then used it to add splatters on the spread. As I had already burned my 5 minutes time limit, I might as well just go full and blow it up completely and finish the spread off in a way that would really, really make my heart sing. And to do that, I needed to add some numbers, of course. Stamping on some numbers in the circles is what makes me happy. But to do that, I needed to make sure that my black paint was dry and that my little bee was protected so that I wouldn't stamp any numbers on the bee. For each month of the Layer a Day challenge, there is actually a matching mixed media sticker sheet, and these combine words that match the challenges as well as artwork. They can help you speed up the process when you don't have 5 minutes that day to put down a layer. For this particular spread, I chose the word I will, because that will, when I look back at my journal years from now, helped me remind that this spread was done for that week where every day I said to myself, tomorrow I will do this and that, and set those little goals for myself. But that little word combined to what it is I have going on my spread would also help me remind how I felt during that week and the growth that I went through. I'm really looking forward to next week's challenge. I hope you will join me Saturday for the new live prompt here on my YouTube channel. To do so, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to hit the little bell so that you receive a notification for when the next live will go up. Before I go, I would like to give a huge shout out to my patrons. You know who you are. You are the most amazing butterfly of all. Don't forget to put down a layer a day this week. See you back next time. Butterfly kisses.